You just got off the phone with Hank Greenberg. Peter described it as a split decision. Maybe Hank Greenberg doesn't see it that way.
It's a mixed, it certainly is going to evoke a mixed reaction within Greenberg's office. Okay, so they are right now trying to get all the facts here from the ruling. They actually had not realized yet that the court had ruled. So we were giving them this information, and Hank said, look, I need to get off the phone, and I need to assess exactly what all of this means. I told him, though, that there are no damages here, and that is going to be a big downside for Hank Greenberg. It's almost a hollow victory here. Yes, he has won the AIG trial, but there are no damages associated with this ruling. This is a very key point for Hank Greenberg. But look, Pim, as you know, as Peter was noting, this was a trial, right, that the odds looked completely against Hank Greenberg here, right? It wasn't until he brought on David Boies and his legal team and that the trial began that people began to feel, wait a minute, Hank Greenberg might really have a shot here at winning this case, and look at where we are now.
And this is a trial in which Ben Bernanke, I believe, testified.
Ben Bernanke,
as well as
Tim Geithner, Hank Paulson. I mean, it was a who's who of the financial crisis roster, right, Pim? I mean, we saw them be paraded down Washington.
Right, because they had, in a sense, relive the days in which the U.S. government came in and, as Peter just described, took the stock of AIG as collateral for money that was then pumped in order to help the company survive the financial crisis.
You know, and David Boies made some very good arguments, right? Arguments that then were published in, followed closely by all the news media that was there, and that also seemed to Pim, judging from the way the judge was questioning the witnesses and counter witnesses themselves, that the judge seemed to almost be siding with AIG, you could tell, during the trial. Now, Hank Greenberg was not on trial during this whole
Well, he brought the case against the U.S. government, right?
Of course. And he was down there several times watching the various witnesses testify, like Ben Bernanke, like Tim Geithner. But, he raised a very good point. Was this a taking by the government?
Right, a confiscation of private property.
Why did AIG have to pay double-digit interest rates at a time when others were paying barely any interest at all? So, you know, he raised some good points. David Boies, followed up with some really strong ammunition, and here we are. But as I mentioned, it's really a mixed reaction so far, a mixed acceptance by Hank Greenberg, you know, as they were seeking some pretty big damages here. And I'm going to get back on the phone with Hank Greenberg's office. Hopefully we'll be able to get him on the phone to get his immediate reaction. But like I said, he and his staff...
You were delivering the news to them.
That's right. Yeah. He and his staff are right now looking at the facts. And obviously, you know, I'm sure he's going to be on the phone, or he is on the phone as we speak with David Boies and his legal team to assess what to do next.
All right. I want to thank you very much, Betty Lou. I'll see you in just a few moments. I want to bring in Peter Cook, who's been monitoring this. Peter, any update you can give us? Because the contention was that the U.S. government basically confiscated the shares of AIG, and as a result, there was financial harm.
Well, that's right, Pam, that the government was entitled to seek collateral in offering this loan and in taking over AIG as it did, but that the one thing it couldn't take was stock. That was the central thrust of David Boies' argument, and I sat in the courtroom for several sessions, heard most of the testimony from the major players like Paulson and Geithner and Bernanke, and that was the basic gist. And I know that David Boies felt very confident that he had made his case in front of this judge, and effectively what we learned today is he did. But the second part of this case that the government had always maintained was that even if the judge ruled against the government, that there was no damages due here, because the only consequence, if the government hadn't stepped in, would have been bankruptcy anyway.
Well, and Peter, so just to break in, one of the consequences is, at least right now, the shares of AIG are up about 2% in today's trade.
Yeah, and I would also be watching the shares, for example, of Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac today. They could also be affected by this court ruling, not because they were related here, but just that the cases mirror each other because of the bailout terms. You know that there are separate lawsuits involving Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, so I'd keep an eye on that. The other thing, Pam, that I would let everyone know down the line is that it's quite likely this case, and we'll wait to hear what Hank Greenberg does next and David Boies, but everyone who followed this case expected it ultimately to go to the Supreme Court. So this probably is not the final chapter in this case.